Hi, I'm making this video for other math teachers and professors who may have students that are Vietnamese or that are recent Vietnamese immigrants, so that you can see how these students may have different math habits or may use different math notations. I will cover from basic arithmetic to calculus, statistics, probability. I won't go more advanced than that. Although my intended audience is other math professors and teachers, if you are a Vietnamese person that's about to take a math class in the US, you probably will find this helpful to prepare for the differences that you will see as well. And if you know of any differences that I have not mentioned or that I don't know about, please let me know in the comments. Let's get right into it. Let's start with arithmetic. A big difference is the decimal point. In the US, the number pi, for example, is written 3.14. In Vietnam, as in a lot of other countries, is 3.14. The symbol for division, if you have in the US 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3, then in Vietnam is 6 divide using a colon as a symbol for divide. Divide by 2 equals 3. Multiplication. Because a dot in the US is the decimal point, if we're going to take 3 times 14, we put the point above the line. And this is equal to 42. Whereas in Vietnam, because they don't use the dot as decimal point, they just use it as multiplication. So it's just 3.14 is equal to 42. If you're interested, especially if you are a Vietnamese student moving to the US, in order to type this in LaTeX, you use /c. Talk about multiplication. Vietnamese also has a different habit in doing long multiplication. In the US, if we're doing 23 times, let's say 12, we get 46 on the first line, and you get 230 on the second line for a total of 276. In Vietnam, this extra zero here that denotes the 10th place of the number one, is this number one here is not one, is 10. So that's why there's an extra zero there for the 10th place. In Vietnam, they don't do that. They just skip that zero. So 23 times 12 in Vietnam would be still 46 here, but this is just 2, 3 with a blank. So they just shift in a position at a time. A bigger difference is the long division. The US way and the Vietnamese way are like opposite of each other. So let's say if I take 276 divided by 23, which we all know the answer should be 12. Over here will be 276 divided by 23 like this. In the US, it will be written 276 divided by 23. And then we take 1 here, 1 times 23 is 23, subtract together 4, drop a 6, and here's 2, 2 times 23 is 46, for a remainder of 0. Two things are different with the Vietnamese way. First of all, they set up the division differently. Instead of 276 on the right side and 23 on the left, it's 276 on the left and 23 on the right. And instead of having the quotient on top, they have the quotient in the bottom. Now the setup is different, but the way that the calculations are done is also different. The multiplication that gets you this 23 here and the subtraction that gets you the 4 remainder, all of that is not written down. All of that is done in the heads. A Vietnamese would write a 1 here, 1 times 23 is 23, 27 minus 23 is 4. So all of that is done in the head. Oh, yeah, by the way, they also have a habit of marking the first group and still drop the 6 And next number is 2. 2 times 23 is 46. 46 minus 46 is 0. So yeah, the step where the multiplication and the subtraction are done explicitly on paper in the US, in Vietnam, it's all done in the heads. The next difference is approximately equal. In the US, you see two different ways that this symbol is written. It's either one of these two, whereas in Vietnam, it's exclusively just this one. All right, moving on to algebra. An ordered pair or coordinates. In the US, you write x, y. So this point right here, for example, in the US, it would be written 2, 1. In Vietnam, it would be written 2, 1, for a very good reason. They are using the comma for decimal. So they cannot use comma to separate numbers because then it'll be very confusing. The way Vietnamese solve equations also slightly different. It's still the same method, it's just done slightly differently. Actually, first, let's say linear equations. If we have an equation, for example, x over 2 plus 1 is equal to 7, then in the US, it's common to subtract 1 both sides to maintain balance, right? And these cancel, and you get 6 here, and you get x over 2 here with an equal sign. And then you multiply both sides by 2, and the 2s here cancel, and you end up with x equals 12. This is not the solution habit of Vietnamese. Vietnamese are taught a rule or a set of rules. The set of rules says when you move an addition from one side of an equation to the other, you change it to a subtraction and vice versa. Instead of subtracting one both sides, what Vietnamese think of it as moving the plus one to the other side and make it become minus one. Of course, the reason why it works is because we're subtracting one both sides, but that's not the solving habit of Vietnamese. And this is equal to 6. And then same thing with division and multiplication. If you move a multiplication from one side to the other, it becomes the division and vice versa. So this division got multiplied over here and I end up with x equals 6 times 2, which for Vietnamese, they would write with a dot on the line equals to 12. So it's the exact same method. It's just written down differently and thought about differently. And now solve quadratic equations. In the US, basically we teach factoring, and then we teach the quadratic formula that goes minus b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. Vietnamese students would practically almost never factor. And second of all, when Vietnamese use the quadratic formula, they break it up in two. First, they calculate b squared minus 4ac, the discriminant, separately. And they denote it as the Greek letter delta. And then the formula is given as negative b plus or minus square root of delta divided by 2a. So yeah, different habits. Different ways the formula was taught, so different ways is carried out. And logarithms, specifically the common logarithm, log base 10. In the US, we write it as log. So for example, log of 1,000 is equal to 3. In Vietnam, there are basically two ways of doing it, depending on, I guess, depending on which teacher you had or which textbook you had. People may write like in the US, or they may write LG. So if your student uses LG, what that student meant was common log, log base 10. Now moving on to geometry and trigonometry. And this is where there are a lot of differences. Symbols for angles. In the US, angle A is written like this. Angle BAC is written like this. In Vietnam, it's written with the hat on top. So it's A with the cap on top and BAC with the cap on top. And they both mean this angle here. And in the US, we make a distinction between the angle as the geometric structure or geometric figure versus the measure of it, which is a number. So if the angle A here has a measure of, looks like about 50 degrees, then in the US, we'd say measure of angle A is equal to 50 degrees, whereas in Vietnam, they just say the angle A is 50 degrees. Line and line segments. In the US, we make a lot of distinctions between different ways of describing a line. So for example, if we have two points AB and we have a line through it, we'd be writing AB with two-way arrows like that. If we refer to just the segment AB, we'd be writing it as AB with a line that does not extend, no arrows. And if you have a half line, like a ray, that starts at A and that goes in the direction of B and extends infinitely in the direction of B, then we'd be writing as AB arrow like that. In Vietnam, all of these are written AB. And then the context will make clear which of these they're talking about. And in particular, whereas in the US, we have a habit of putting an arrow to denote that the thing goes on indefinitely. In Vietnam, the arrow is used almost exclusively to denote direction only. So if there's an AB with an arrow on it, then it's a vector. It's almost exclusively used as a vector only. Related to that, if we have a number line in the US, a lot of people have a habit of putting arrows on both sides to denote that it goes on forever. In Vietnam, the arrow only goes one way. The arrow in Vietnam only means direction. It doesn't mean extension to infinity. So that's why it goes only in one direction that says this is the increasing direction. And the same thing with the y-axis and the z-axis. The arrow only goes one way. Okay, and that's the way in the US we use the arrow. We use the arrow to denote direction, yes, of course, but also to denote that things extend indefinitely. And in Vietnam, they don't do that. Congruence. If you have two triangles ABC and DEF that are the same, so ABC looks like this, and DEF also looks like this, then in the US, we use a special symbol to denote that they're congruent. They're more than just equal. They're congruent in the sense that they fit exactly on top of each other. It's a very special relationship. In Vietnam, it's just like they're equal. So they just use the equal symbol. Parallel. The symbol in the US is two vertical parallel lines. And the symbol in Vietnam are two slanted parallel lines. So we say line L is parallel to line M. Over here is line L parallel to line M. For trig, tangent of X. In Vietnam, it's also written tangent of X, but you may see some older students write it as TGX like this. Students in Vietnam are not taught secant and cosecant, so they don't know about secant of X and they don't know about cosecant of X. So if a result comes out 1 over cosine X, they just leave it as 1 over cosine X. For example, the formula that says derivative of tangent of x is secant squared, Vietnamese just call it derivative of tangent of x is 1 over cosine squared. Set theory. Some slight differences. Set builder notation, or we write all x such that certain property. Vietnamese use a slanted line instead of straight line, all x such that property. The natural numbers in Vietnam includes 0. When you see a Vietnamese student write n store, they mean n, but not including the 0 elements. So basically, the 1, 2, 3, except that again, because comma is used for decimal place, it's 1, 2, 3, etc. And interval notation, exactly the same, except again for the comma and the semicolon. So the interval from 0 to 3, the half closed, half open interval, is in Vietnam written with a semicolon. Probability and statistics, mostly in probability. The binomial coefficient. In the US, we write it as N choose K, or N choose K like this. In Vietnam, it's C, N here and K up there. So the numbers are opposite. The big number goes in the bottom and the small number goes on top. And the same thing with permutation, N, PK is P, N, K like this. And in particular, N, P, N is written as just P, N, which is equal to N factorial. N and or probability. In the US, let's say that we say that P of A NB, sometimes we spell it out. Sometimes we use the logical symbol. Sometimes we use the ampersand. In Vietnam, it's just PANB like this. It does remind them, helpfully, I hope, that it leads to a multiplication of some sort. And same thing with OR. If A or B, and in Vietnam, they use a plus sign for it. By the way, I am not sure if this is universal. I've seen plenty of exercise books that use it, but I don't know if it's universal. And lastly, we arrive at calculus. A limit of a sequence. If you have a sequence A sub N, and you want to calculate the limit of this sequence, then it's the limit as n goes to infinity of a sub n. If you think about it, when you have a sequence and you calculate the limit of it, the only limit we calculate is the limit as n goes to infinity. No other limit. So in Vietnam, they actually just skip it. They just write lim of a sub n. Limits of functions are written just like us because, you know, it does make a difference where the variable x goes to. But for sequence, it's kind of like what other limits are there. And the last thing is that a Vietnamese student will almost like 100%, almost all of them would write vector as a row vector only. So it will take them time to get in the habit of writing vectors as a column vector. And on top of that, yeah, they write as a row vector and they put semicolon in between the coordinates. These are the differences that I can think of. If you can think of some more, please let me know in the comments below. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more contents and bye.